My exotic family, it's your boy Dre. Welcome back to another video. So today's video is actually going to kind of go hand in hand with my last video. If you haven't seen it, my last video actually covered quarantine and why you should quarantine, why it's important. And I also gave, you know, a few tips and tricks on how you should go about quarantining. So this video is actually, we're going to discuss mites. Reason I want to kind of, you know, cover this topic is because it's something that I personally dealt with, but also something when dealing with reptiles is something I think is important. That some people do overlook. Nobody really wants to admit, I got mites or whatever. But I definitely wanted to kind of put this video together to discuss mites and, you know, how to prevent it, how we can, you know, make sure that we keep our reptiles healthy. And just if we do come across the issue, we can solve it quickly. So stay tuned. So what exactly is a mite, or a Phainisis natricis is the scientific name. Basically, it's a parasite most commonly found in snakes, but it also can be found in lizards and other, you know, reptiles as well. Definitely something, if you see it, it's not necessarily a good thing. So it's definitely something we want to kind of, you know, nip in the bud very quickly. Obviously, you know, if they're around long enough, they can kill a reptile. So it's definitely something we want to make sure that we get solved initially. So mites actually can be passed from reptile to reptile, which is why it's important to quarantine. This is why I said this is going to be in addition to the last video. So basically, if you have a reptile room and you have, you know, one or two reptiles with mites, and you handle all of your reptiles, you increase the chances of passing those mites on from one reptile to the next, which is definitely a big no-no in the reptile community, but also nobody wants to deal with that headache. It's one thing to have one reptile with mites, but once it actually spreads to your collection, it can definitely become a headache and a nightmare, and nobody wants to deal with that because it can cost a lot of money and just cause issues, and everyone knows those mites are a terror to, you know, try to get rid of. So definitely make sure you quarantine, you know, set them up somewhere completely different, but also your tail. Also, just make sure that if you do have animals in quarantine, they're the last ones you handle, you know, before handling any other reptiles. So it's probably easier to, if you need to, handle all your other reptiles before you get to your quarantine area. Alrighty, so let's talk symptoms. We hear of mites, let's talk symptoms of mites. Symptoms of mites could be, you know, taking super extremely long soaks in their water dish. If you, you know, look at your reptile close enough, or as you can see Medusa here, you know, it can be hard to see on some reptiles, but if you have a lighter colored snake or a snake that's white and you're noticing these super dark specks, but they're moving, that is probably one of the clearest indication that you are dealing with mites. But also, you know, irritability, you know, it's a parasite, you know, sucking the blood out of them, so it does irritate their scales. You know, the mites like to go up under their scutes and, you know, just kind of hang out there. But also, possibly, I haven't seen it in all reptiles or snakes, but I have seen it, lack of appetite. Some snakes will not eat because they're so irritated, or they just don't want to eat. So that's definitely, you know, a few things that you want to look out for. In addition to, like I said, if you physically see the mites on the reptile, that's probably going to be your best indicator right there. Alrighty, so how do we treat mites? You know, you get mites, how do we treat them? Basically, like I said, quarantine is going to be important. And what you'll definitely need to do is, you know, remove the snake from the enclosure, soak the snake. And that may have to be something that happens repeatedly. If you see the mites, you can literally pick them off by hand, or if you have some small tweezers, you can get them off that way. But you definitely, while the snake is soaking, or a reptile, I keep saying snake, but while your reptile is soaking, you're definitely going to want to strip everything completely from that enclosure. Some people, you know, if they deal with mites, they'll just, you know, still use the same decorations. They'll just kind of bleach them and everything. Me personally, I just throw everything out and start from scratch. but definitely strip the enclosure, take all of the substrate, any, you know, cork bark or any driftwood or anything. To me, that's going in the trash. But we definitely want to make sure that we actually not just remove the substrate, but we want to give it a good wipe down as well. Me personally, I like to use F10 solution or, you know, a little bleach water, never hurt. But those are like my two go-tos. So we definitely want to, you know, bleach down the enclosure, or just disinfect. And then from that point on, that animal is in quarantine. I usually like to use paper towel. So I literally will set them up in my quarantine enclosures. They're super bare. So I'll set them up in paper towel, a hide, and a water dish. And that's usually it. So that it's just easier for me to keep an eye on them like that. And then especially if you're using paper towel, it's all white, it's easier for you to see the mites come off so you can see if they're there or not. So those are definitely some important things that you want to keep in mind while you're trying to treat for mites. And then, of course, once the mites are, you know, actually gone, you're going to want to make sure. And then obviously, once you start up that quarantine period, you are going to want to definitely check on that snake daily just to see if they're making progress. Make sure the mites aren't worsening, making sure the, you know, the snake isn't, you know, deteriorating, because I have seen that happen as well, where snake will have, you know, a case of the mites so bad or so severe that it makes a turn for the worse. So you definitely want to make sure that you are checking daily. Whenever you see any mites, you want to dispose of them. You know, what, literally you can wipe them off of the snake. They're usually pretty easy to spot. Only problem is if you have a darker snake, like maybe Khalifa or Kato for me, or a Mexican Black King snake, they're impossible to see because they are so dark. But we definitely want to make sure that we're making, you know, checking daily, which me personally, I think checking your reptiles daily is something you should do anyway. But you know, if you're dealing with mites or any other type of sickness, you know, respiratory, anything like that, you definitely are gonna wanna make sure that you are checking on their progress daily, just to ensure that they're actually making progress, or if you need to change, you know, medication or switch up something you're doing, you have time to make that adjustment versus just checking every couple of days and you don't catch something in time. So lastly, I would like to talk about is just, how do you prevent, you know, from getting mites? Mites is something that, like I said, when you have a lot of reptiles, it is kind of something that a lot of people do deal with. So preventing it, I would say, number one, whenever you get any new reptile, like I said before in the last video, quarantine. Whether it's 30, 60, 90, however long you need it to be, I would recommend at least 30 days. But you always want to quarantine that animal, usually outside of your reptile room. I know obviously not everyone has the space for that, but do the best you can. But you definitely, the goal is to make sure that new reptile is as far away from your established reptile, you know, animals, as far away from them as possible. Number two, always disinfect. Whether it's a new enclosure, new decoration, new food bowl, water bowl, whatever the case may be, you always want to disinfect. Me personally, if I get something new from the store or wherever I get it from, it can be brand new on the shelf. I don't know how long it's been sitting there. I don't know what was in it. So when I usually get home, all of my new decorations that I do buy, I actually bleach them, and then I rinse them, and then I dry them before I even use them. So that's definitely a great way to disinfect. That goes for my decorations as well. So I mentioned F10, which is a veterinary cleaner. It's very good. I don't know why, but my go-to is always going to be, it's always bleach. I guess for me, it's always readily available. And when I say bleach, I don't mean strictly just bleach. Obviously it's diluted with water. But that's my go-to. But those are probably going to be the biggest, preventers, as well as, you know, just your common husbandry. Make sure you're washing your hands. Obviously, like I mentioned before, if you have a reptile you think is sick or is sick, just make sure you're washing your hands in between handling your reptiles. But as mentioned before, just make sure that you're handling those animals with the mites or whatever they may have last. And then another thing that I did not mention that I want to mention now, there are also you know, mite removers as far as chemicals that you can use on your reptiles that are reptile safe. Me, I try to stray away from them. I mean, I haven't, you know, dealt with mites in a while, at least not in this reptile room. I haven't, but when I had some of my previous reptiles, I did deal with them, but I try to stay away from a lot of those reptiles just because I don't like using a lot of chemicals directly on my reptiles. But for those of you that, you know, you need a quick go-to and need a solution, they do sell them. There's Mite Off, which is, you know, one of the more well-known products, and there's a few others. Mite Off is probably the one I'm most expensive with, or most familiar with, I'm sorry. But it's a pretty good product. I have used it, you know, once or twice. But like I said, I just don't like to use a lot of chemicals with my reptiles directly. But for the most part, dealing with mites is pretty easy to take care of. We just have to make sure we're mindful of our husbandry. Also make sure our sanitation procedures, I guess you could say. You know, if you come in from outside, me personally, I think it's better if you actually wash your hands before, you know, even touching your reptiles. It's just the small things we do can definitely, you know, kind of decrease the chances of things we pass onto our reptiles. And it's just less you have to worry about, in my opinion. Those are some of the practices I have in my reptile room. I know everyone's different. I'm not saying you have to do everything that I'm saying in this video to the T, but it's definitely something that you know, I've done, and it's definitely helped with me. None of these particular reptiles have had mites, and I do everything I can to make sure they don't get mites. I spot clean, you know, multiple times a week. So for me, every day is cleaning day, basically. But also, I also inspect my reptiles on the daily. I know I take a lot of pictures on Instagram, and there's a lot of work that goes in behind those pictures. I mean, I'm taking them, you know, I'm literally, you know, looking at them, because for those of you that actually spend a lot of time with your reptiles, you'll know when something's off. You know when something looks different, and I think that's very important. That is going to be the big difference between, you know, if it is a mite or not. If you catch it early, then it's usually not an issue. But as far as mites, that is pretty much it. Pretty summed up. I could go more in depth, but I didn't want to make this a super long video. Hopefully you guys liked it. Hopefully it was informational for you. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment or hit me up on Instagram in the DMs. Make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell, and as always, stay exotic.